standing by to do a take on the first promotion?
I name this power car HTV West.
I'm not going to have anything for the Christmas tape again. You're trying to wind me up, you bastard.
Will you please welcome the producer of the show that you will see on your television screens from HTV West, Derek Clark.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Welcome to this recording.
Thank you, Derek. And now on HTV West, we go over to Stingray. Excuse me. Really? I'm terribly sorry. It's the news.
We are about to launch Stingray. Anything can happen in the next half hour.
Obviously, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Zero.
They're honest.
51 seconds
on
this.
Cue
Richard.
Well, first,
coming to two.
Take
it.
Four.
Three next. We then go to
BT8
on item 3.
Can I warn you, Maggie? Yeah. This item is not yet edited. We just wait for the late item to arrive and spot it when we can.
Right. Alison will be on camera one for the next item, which will be fair.
And the punchline was he was on 6T all the time.
Christ, call the phone. Hello? Yeah, right, hold on, yeah, he's here. It's you, John.
Hi. Yeah. What? 3 minutes?
Go and edit this now.
Right. Chris, just put the last shot on. We'll take it.
Last shot. Come in now, John. It's coming now.
Ring the box. Tell him I'm on my way.
Sure. Hello?
Yeah, right.
Hello? Stan? He's on his way, no problem. No problem at all.
Detectives in the West are hunting a thief who they've christened E.T. after the alien in Steven Spielberg's film. The man, who has a leathery and wrinkled face, is one of a pair of thieves who are believed to have netted £50,000 worth of goods in raids on houses in Wiltshire, Somerset and Dorset.
Right. ENG for B2. Is it there yet?
Yes.
2 minutes.
Tell us,
Mike, can we want to be the reception
casualty? I think on Saturday we will see something of a breather, though, but on Sunday it looks like we're going to see rain returning and it's going to get windy again, Richard. So if you're going to do it on Saturday.
10, 9, roll VT2, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, 2, 1, take it, cue Ali.
Stand by VT7, please, thank you.
Terry, give us the tape, give us the tape!
ENG,
give us the tape!
Well, I'm still, there's a room for
you. No, come on, this is no time for jokes.
Try that one.
Now the closing headlines from ITN. It's just been announced that Anne Diamond has flown to Hollywood for auditions as Batman 2. Here in Bristol, police were called to a disturbance involving two motorists after a car bonnet was dented during a fight. Police are still looking for an HTV engineer calling himself Ken Banwell. Police are also investigating a most unusual crime at Arnersdale Crematorium. Yellow carnations from Reeves are being stolen on a regular basis.
Next sunshine, all right?
A crematorium spokesperson said we have no idea where they're going. Police are looking for ladies in blue uniforms who've been acting suspiciously and returning to the HTV staff canteen.
He's been dropped!
This year, millions of people have been invited to this spot to visit a company that provides the fuel which supplies one-fifth of all the electricity we use. Already, thousands of people have been to British Nuclear Fuels and seen for themselves. Because the facts at the Sellafield Exhibition Centre are there.
As we can see, that scourge of the network, the intergalactic toilet, has now materialized in the car park of HTV. And what threat to our planet is it carrying today? Haha! It is the independent Cyberman, determined to show us Earthlings that a single alien can do the job of an entire station. Very enterprising. Oh dear, it seems our Cyberman is already in need of some refreshment. A large stein of Beck's, perhaps? Or perhaps he would rather be hemorrhaging. Clearly, our Cyberman has broken down. So we must call Ken in CAR. Ho, ho, ho! And once again, it is demonstrated that Banwell Ken misplaces the parts that other gears cannot reach.
No, really? How big? No. Yeah. Oh, shit, I'm on air, actually. I'll call me back in a few minutes. Yeah, all right. And now back to the programme.
Let's see what this word is. Come on, let's have it for Che. There you go, Che.
Bates.
Master.
So that's what I used to do, was it?
Until now, no one has dared to say what this film says, because it tells us things about ourselves we do not wish to know.
Let's see what this word is. Come on, let's have it for Che. There you go, Che.
Bates.
Master.
So that's what I used to do, was it?
Until now, no one has dared to say what this film says, because it tells us things about ourselves we do not wish to know.
Finally, Mr. Conabier, it has been widely suspected for a long time that the journalists in the BBC are nothing but a bunch of pinkos, left-wing commie bastards. I mean, aren't you just proving that?
No, I think this demonstrably is not the case.
Excuse me.
Look, you can start now because I have finished, okay? But don't be so damned rude.
Don't attack me, Brenda.
Don't be so rude, Brenda.
Don't touch me again, mate.
Don't make any difference, Brenda. I won't let you do it again. I've had enough of you.
My name is...
You're stupid.
Excuse me.
And you're unprofessional.
Excuse me. Oh, shit. Sorry, I have to go again. Sorry. Can I just go? Sunset Boulevard, where the names of the movie stars are immortalized on the sidewalk. But one name is missing, and it's that of Diana Dawes. Now, back in the 50s, she was enormously popular over here, so why isn't her name here? I'm sure that the population of Los Angeles know all about her. I'm going to ask her passers-by. Excuse me, sir. Do you know anything about Diana Dawes?
Of course I do, you cunt. We're making a documentary about her, aren't we?
And now for the latest news from Cheltenham.
Andy's off at the starting gate. A superb thoroughbred, well hung out of the eye of a knocking bollocks. Neymar's recently out to stunt, but he had promised to soak him. Oh, and what's this? A hole in one. He's down. No, no, he's up. It's up. I mean, he's up. I mean, there he goes. Look at him. Past the finishing post. A sturdy stallion if we've ever seen one.
Mark Austin, ITN Sport, Cheltenham.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm certainly glad I didn't have my money on that one. I think I'd have had my assets frozen. He certainly did. Anyway, now we go over to something slightly more agricultural, and for this we need to put our wellies on, as we've just seen what the weather's like, and it's time, of course, for West Country Farming.
Yes, there's a degree of happiness there.
Don't take any notice of him. He's as biased as they come. Have a dry bone.
Well, this year. Have an oggy this year.
So, thank you very much. Keep the phones, the phone calls coming.
And QLE cut.
I had a delightful thing through the post this morning. Take a closer look at this. Isn't it wonderful? I wonder who this is modelled on.
It's all yours.
This was sent in by... I've a green finger, have you indeed? You look like you might have a bit more than that. Ooh, is that Samantha Fox? My God.
Peter, can we leave
She's
that?
Got bigger knockers than me.